Peace be to you, brothers and sisters. This evening, we celebrate the sixth day anticipated Simbanga B Mass. Please all rise and welcome our presider, Reverend Father Richard Garrido, our parochial administrator.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We adore you, we glorify you, we give
Let us pray. Merciful Lord, hear the prayers of your people who celebrate the coming of your Son in human flesh, that when he comes again in glory, we may gain the prize of eternal life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. The Song of Songs reflects God's love for his people, Israel. Here, the young woman who symbolizes the people is delighted when the bridegroom, who is the Lord, comes to visit her.
A reading from the Song of Songs. Hark, my lover, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks, he says to me, "Arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. For see, the winter is past, the rains are over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of pruning the vines has come, and the song of the dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines in bloom give forth fragrance. Arise, my beloved, my beautiful one, and come. O my dove in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and you are lovely." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Give thanks to the Lord on the harp with a 10-stringed lyre. Chant his praises, sing to him a new song. Pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
But the plan of the Lord stands forever, the design of his heart through all generations. Bless the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust.
Exalt you just in the Lord, sing to him a new song. Please all rise. Emmanuel, our King and Giver of Law, come to save us, Lord our God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out in those days and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, today we are celebrating day 6 of our novena. And the Lord give us these beautiful readings, these powerful readings to help us. If you remember, before yesterday, we received the gospel where the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and told her that you're going to conceive, to bear a son, and this is the Son of God, and the Holy Spirit will overshadow you. And Mary believed and answered, "Let it be done to me according to your word." These brothers and sisters, because she received this word, and now she has the courage and the strength to go, and to go and to see Elizabeth, her cousin. And brothers and sisters, we can ask ourselves, and I will ask you, have you experienced doing things because of a word, because you have received a message, because you believed, and this word gives you the power to do things? Have you experienced that? Because of listening to the word of God, because of coming to the Eucharist, because of receiving Jesus Christ, it gives us a power and a strength to go and not to be afraid. Have you? Huh? And we need to ask the Lord, the intercession of Mama Mary, to help us on this. Because sometimes when we come to Mass, we come like that. And then we go home like that. Why is it? Because I am not expecting anything. I come into Mass, but no expectation, no desire to listen and to receive a word that can change my heart and give me the strength to enter into the new mission that the Lord is giving me. That is why the word, when we say word, sometimes we do not understand this. Word for us is something, I don't know, about salita, abstract, because we speak a lot. Our words are no. I have already many friends that I already know. At the beginning, I believe. "Oh, Father, I will give you this and this and that." And then, voila. And then you will say it again. "So now I know you." Don't. It's dito to. And our words are like that. We say many words, but yes, I will be there at 8 p.m. Yes, and then I'll arrive at 9. This is our words. But for the Jewish people, word is not something abstract. Words is together with action and cannot be separated. That is why you remember this passage in Genesis when God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. "There, let there be the moon and the star," and there was moon and star. When God speaks, is action, it's power. That is why with Jesus Christ, you remember, when Jesus Christ will perform miracles, he will not say prayers or like that. He will say, "Be cleansed," and the leprosy goes. He will say, "Open your eyes," and he can see. He will say to the demons, "Be quiet, go out," and they have to go out. Because the word is power. It's power. So brothers and sisters, today in this Eucharist, we come to receive a word like Mama Mary, that gives us the grace to go and becomes one with me. When I was 20 years old, I was in Colombia, I was 19, 20, and then they told me, "You have been chosen." "Chosen for what?" to go wherever the Lord wants to send you. Ay, nako, hindi ako pwede. I cannot. I am the only child, a single mother. I have to take care of my mother, and I cannot. But why? No, I feel very poor. I have no strength. And you know what the rector told me that time? This is the best way you can feel, because at the end you will see that it was the Lord. Nako, if I knew, I will say, kaya ko to, sige na. But the truth was, this was the truth. No, I cannot, hindi puede. And then they said, do not be afraid. At the end, all the glory will be to God. Well, yes, after I was sent Italy, from Italy, they pick up the country and came out. Manila, Richard, well, naku, where is that? And I was sent to Manila, and I was crying here every night, homesick, missing my mother, everything. And I never imagined that the Lord will transform my heart and make me love the Philippines. And now I am 24 years here. And I look back, and I can say, it is because of this word. The word that is given in our poverty, when we cannot make it. And we receive a word that keeps us in our journey, through our tears, through our sufferings. And this word bears fruits. This is why we come to the celebration of the Eucharist. This is why we come to this novena, to receive this word. This word is Jesus Christ. Today in this Eucharist, I love the gospel of today. And because Mary was one with this word, the moment she spoke, Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she said, oh, blessed are you. How is it possible that the mother of my Lord would come to me? Because at the moment your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. And because of this word, the words that we speak are different. They bring peace. If you receive this word today, receiving this word means that you believe. Elizabeth understood this very well because she was filled with the Holy Spirit. Blessed are you, Bucket, because she said, because you believe that the promises made to you will be fulfilled. Because she believed. Receiving this word means, to welcome this word means to believe that the God has power to do miracles in my life. Once this word is in us, I tell you, we can go home and speak. Speak to your children. Speak to your wife. Speak to the people around them and bring them peace. Peace. Bring that peace. Let us bring that peace. Speak to your helper, to your driver, to whomever in the house, or to your mother-in-law. Bring peace, because they will sense that you and I are one with this word, which is Jesus Christ. Let us ask the Lord for this gift. Let us receive this word and allow this word, Christ, to do miracles in our life. We can stand for the prayer of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, let us ask God to help us imitate His Son's perfect faithfulness, obedience, and humility. He is our King and example towards fullness of life. In every prayer we say, come and save us, Lord our God.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
Loving God, come and save your church so that we may always remain a channel of your communion and salvation. We pray.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
Loving God, come and save all public servants as they render selfless service to our country. We pray.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
Loving God, come and save our heart, mind, and will our entire being as we face the day-to-day struggles of life, we pray.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
Loving God, come and save our departed loved ones and embrace them into your eternal communion, we pray.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Come and save us, Lord our God.
God, our Father, come and ready our hearts to welcome your Son, the Emmanuel, our King and way to fullness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, accept from your church these gifts, which in your mercy you have given us to offer, and which by your power You transform into the sacrament of our salvation. Grant this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, to together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ remains everlasting. The body of Christ.
Amen. Let us pray.
Lord, may the divine mysteries we have shared keep your people safe from harm, so that ever faithful to your service, we may enjoy salvation of mind and body. Grant this in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated for a short announcement. We would like to appeal again to your kind and generous hearts to help us with our Tree of Hope program. Please help us reach our goal to send 30 scholars to the Technical Vocational Education and Training Center of Don Bosco, Makati. The training cost per student is about 45,000 pesos, and we still have a long way to go. Please consider giving to the Tree of Hope so that their dreams of having a good education and a future job can be fulfilled. Our volunteers shall be waiting for you outside the church after this Mass. Thank you very much to those who have already showed their support to this cause. Congratulations to all of you who have completed 6 days of our Aguinaldo Masses. 3 more days to go. Please take note of our Christmas Mass and New Year's Mass schedules on the LED screen. Thank you. Thank you. Please all rise for the final blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
Proclaim the joyful message that our God is coming to earth. Let the valleys be filled and the mountains be low, preparing for his holy birth. He will come in the spirit of wisdom. The poor and